Hi, this is Paul Stolt from iPhone Dev TV. We're going to get started with creating our very first Xcode project. There's two ways to do it. I'm going to show you both ways. The first thing you'll look at is creating a new Xcode project right here. You can just click on this. But if you don't see this window on start, the next best place is to look in the File, New, Project menu. So if we just click on this, that will bring up the new project. And what you want to focus on here is iOS, Application, and then single view application. So just stick with this and then hit next down here in the bottom right corner, and we can give it a name. So we can call this our Swift app. You can give it whatever name you want right here. Then we have our organization name. This is whatever you want to call it. This can be your company. This can be you. An organization identifier is going to identify you to Apple. Now, test start, this just needs to be a unique value, so you can type anything you want here. They recommend a reverse website if you own a website. If you are an iOS developer, this needs to be the same value so that you can actually make your app work on your iPhone and submit it to the App Store. For now, you can just type anything. Next, we have Swift, which is the language that we'll be targeting with these new courses, but you can choose Objective-C if you want to. And lastly, we have devices that are supported. Universal means both iPhone and iPad. And sometimes I find it easier to start with iPhone, but there's new changes in iOS 8 that makes it easier to do a universal app. So we'll just stick with that for now. What you can do here is then hit next to continue. And I put my projects in my desktop folder. So just click on desktop here. And then I have a projects folder and we can just place it in there. So if you just double click, it'll automatically create it and put it in there, or you can hit that create button. Now, I did create that really quickly with the Git account enabled. And if you don't want to do that, you can uncheck that. I don't really recommend using Git right now. It's a version control, which is to help you track the code as you write it so that if you mess up, you can go back to an older version. So it's kind of like Time Machine, but it's for source code and project files. So now you're ready to begin. Just hit the play button and that will cause an iPhone app to appear. Now, you might get a couple dialogues when you first start Xcode. They're going to ask you to enable developer mode on Mac. Just accept those and you can get started. You'll need higher permissions on your Mac to run some of these applications in order to make the iPhone apps. But once you enable that, you'll be able to get off the ground and get going. So now that we have the iPhone app running, let's just make one code change so that we can see something appear in the Xcode console window. So I'm going to open up the View Controller class on the left. So this is in the Project Navigator. Clicking on this file once will bring up the source code. Now, unlike Visual Studio or other code editors, if you're coming from Windows, you don't need to double click twice. If you double click twice, you will see another window appear. You can just go ahead and close that one. Just click once on the files. And then in the ViewDidLoad method, right down here, we are going to add one line of code and we're going to do a print statement. So it's going to be print ln for print line. We're just going to say hi. Now, to make it a little bit more personal, let's put your name there. So I'll just say hi, Paul! Exclamation mark, and I want you to change that to whatever your name is. We'll stop the app by hitting the stop button right here, and then we'll hit the play button right here. So if we start the app, we again see the blank canvas. So what we're looking at is the iPhone screen, but there's nothing in it right now. We haven't dragged any UI onto it. So it's completely blank. It's a blank slate for us to work with. But if we click back on Xcode now down here, we can see that Xcode just said hi to us. So our first iPhone app just said hi. And now we're really ready to get started learning how to design the user interface, learning how to design the code, and then learning how those two can connect to each other and sort of coexist to make our iPhone app that we can submit to the App Store. All right. Thanks for watching, and if you have any other questions, just send me an email or find me on Twitter. You can find me at pulsolt@iphonedev.tv.